Okay, first things first. I have to apologize for the video this morning cutting out early. I record these on my phone, and the issue with that is it only keeps so much available space, and I didn't check how much space was available before I started the video, and once I made it past 13 minutes and 31 seconds, it said no more. So I had to delete a few things in order to make some room. But we're back on track. Basically, I ended it by saying, you know, I'm responsible for making kids work hard and earn what they deserve, not just receive handouts. Make them used to working and not used to just getting what they want because they said they want it. So that's how I ended that video. Now, this afternoon, we had an assembly at school in the last part of the day. And there are arguments made for having assemblies at the end of the day and having assemblies at the beginning of the day, and, you know, does it affect how the rest of the day goes, whatever. This one was a doozy. The presenter, it was for a fundraiser, first of all. We're starting a new fundraiser. Brand new company that we've never worked with before. And so they wanted to introduce it to the kids. It's all well and good. Get them excited about raising money for the school and whatnot. But the presenter was extremely energetic, very loud. Like, extremely loud. He was using a microphone and yelling into the microphone. So it was just extremely booming and piercing and, like, just really, really crazy. And that was more than I wanted to handle, especially with a group of kids who don't know how to monitor or self-control in a situation like that. It's just beyond enough. There's no part of me that wants to sit there surrounded by a group of 700 kids screaming and yelling and not being able to understand that you can be excited on the inside without dancing and hooting and hollering on the outside. It drives me nuts. And I have two students in particular, and I sat them next to me strategically, hoping that, oh, they're like, well, I'm right next to Mr. Gilly, and I'm not going to act up. No, they have no connection to that. They don't understand, like, oh, I'm next to the teacher. I should probably behave myself. It's more like, I'm next to the teacher. I can get away with more. And I kid you not, I gave these kids three warnings and said, on the next time, I'm writing you up. And so what did I do? I ended up writing them up because they don't know how to stop when it's time to stop. So it was just frustrating to be at that assembly and to have to sit through a presentation of essentially the same thing. You look at the brochure, you try to convince people to buy it, you earn some prizes. Now, I will say that the prizes that this group offers, this company offers, are some pretty legit prizes, but these kids have to sell like upwards of 30 things, like not $30, but 30 individual items in order to earn like any prize that's worthwhile. And, you know, that may be no hard task for a standard community, but this community is one, only about 3,000 people, 700 of which are in the elementary school, and another 700 to 800, 600 to 700 in the junior high and high school. So about 1,600 people, or portion of the population, out of 3,000 or 3,300 is students in the school that aren't going to be buying anything. And they're not all from separate families either. Obviously, you have siblings and cousins and whatnot all throughout this community. Second thing is, it's a low-income community. It's people, like I said this morning, that are on welfare, that are using food stamps, that are, you know, living off of state funding, whether legitimate or illegitimate. But we'll forget that I said that. And so they're not going to go and throw a couple extra dollars at some knockoff item or food thing that they're going to just eat and then be done with, when it could go towards something else. So it's hard for one kid to go out and sell 30 items alone, but for 700 kids all pining for the same people, the same grandparents, the same aunts and uncles, the same secretaries and teachers and all these things, the people that can afford these things and can pay for them, they're all going after the same ones. And so it's not easy to do that. That coupled with they only have 2 weeks to do it in. It's not like they're working for a month and they have time to take it out and go and sell and be out and about or have mom and dad take it to work or whatever. They don't have that luxury. And the fourth kind of con to this whole fundraiser business is that we just got back from spring break. Like, if you're going to kick off a new fundraiser, do it before spring break so the kids have free time to go out and sell and make money back. Don't do it after when they're stuck at school and don't have the time to get out there and do it. So, I don't know. I'm all for fundraisers. Like I said, you got to earn money somehow. But there are just a few logistic things and that don't really make sense to me when it comes to preparing for them and setting up for them. So, that is what it is. That's what we did with the last hour of our day today. It was not fun. It was not enjoyable. But it's done. Now I just have to pay attention for the next 2 weeks as these envelopes come in with money and order forms and whatnot. And, you know, keep track of all that stuff, which just adds to my stress and confusion and frustration on top of everything else that comes with the end of the school year. So, I know it doesn't sound like I enjoy my job, but I really do love my job. When I'm able to do my job, when I'm able to teach, I love it. It's all the extra stuff, the meetings, the paperwork, the planning for field trips and conferences and phone calls that really, really frustrates me. So, not the best of days today. Monday and Tuesday were definitely better. But we take each day. Tomorrow is a new one. We'll see what happens. That's about all I got. Short video this afternoon. I'm just going to kind of cruise on home, de-stress, decompress, and I'll see you back in the morning. See ya. Bye. Adios.